So is there anything that puts you at risk for type 1 diabetes, Dr. Paraskos?
Type 1 diabetes, unfortunately, is mostly genetic. So family history is the biggest risk factor for diabetes, which means, unfortunately, there's not a lot that you can do to prevent it. It's something that we just have to continue to monitor for and keep an eye on, especially in patients that have a family history of diabetes, type mm-hmm. 1 diabetes, or other autoimmune conditions.
Okay, so let's shift to type 2 then. Mm-hmm. So there are a lot more risk factors for this type of diabetes. You said it has a lot to do with a lifestyle. So can we go through this list together as what can contribute to type 2 diabetes, starting with your weight?
Absolutely. Weight is probably the biggest risk factor okay. for type 2 diabetes. You know, patients that are overweight have more insulin resistance, which, like we showed in the graphic before, is the cornerstone for type 2 diabetes. Inactivity, not exercising, not moving, right. that also increases your insulin resistance and contributes to weight, so that can contribute to the risk factor for diabetes. High blood pressure and abnormal cholesterol are also things that we see in patients with type 2 diabetes, again, mostly because of lifestyle. Family history, we talked about, is also a part of type 2 diabetes. Type 2 diabetes mostly is lifestyle, but there is a very big genetic component, so that's also something to keep an eye out for, especially if you have a family history, to get screened early on, as well as age and race. We see in the population gets older, the risks for diabetes increases as well.
And with race, mm-hmm. there's specific race that actually are more prone to diabetes. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Sure. Some races are, especially Hispanic Hispanic patients, as well as African Americans, have a higher incidence of diabetes and have a higher risk factors for diabetes.
Wow.